for this event today, that if any koi bhi chhatra sangathan agar aaj zinda hai uske liye sabko badhai dena chahiye kyunki jo agar itne log ya isse kam ya isse zyada ekjut hokar ke koi agar nischay karte hain ki hum ladenge, that is something to be celebrated. Because aaj jo hamari avastha hai usme it's very clear. I'll do mix Hindi English or English. Is there somebody who doesn't understand Hindi at all? Thodi thodi? Huh? I'll mix it. Okay. So the fact that anybody is left standing today is actually a miracle. And we have to understand that there are this whole assault on this country. Ye jo country pe hamare desh ke upar ek war kiya hai sangwad ne. उसके दो तीन फेजेस थे. सबसे पहले 2014 से समझे 2016 फरवरी तक एक पूरी चुप्पी साधी गई थी क्योंकि एक इतने बड़े पॉपुलर वोट से एक इलेक्शन लड़ा गया था और जीता गया था बीजेपी और संघ के, एंड लोग बहुत ही बिल्कुल कुछ बोलने को तैयार नहीं थे. तो जो सबसे बड़ा हमला हुआ पहले वो कौन सा हुआ? यूनिवर्सिटीज़ के ऊपर. और जवाहरलाल नेहरू यूनिवर्सिटी, रोहित पहले यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हैदराबाद और फिर जवाहरलाल नेहरू यूनिवर्सिटी. तो आप लोग में से कुछ तो साथ रहे होंगे उस टाइम और कुछ अभी स्कूल में थे या दूसरे कॉलेजेस में थे. तो आपने देखा होगा कि जो एक द वे दैट पीपल रोज अप, फर्स्ट दिस यूनिवर्सिटी रोज अप, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हैदराबाद रोज अप, and the way that the influence this had across the country, that is, it was not only a JNU movement, and many of us are very proud of that. Uske liye bilkul hame apne aap ko congratulate bhi karna chahiye ki humne jo ek itna bada hamla tha usko humne pichhada. But the problem is that when we get stuck in the moment, so if we get stuck in the moment and think that okay, now we defeated them, which many people in JNU did, which is why a students union election was fought as if we had won the war, right? We saw that there was a great crisis generally of the student unions across the universities after that February 2016 to July, let's say June, July 2016 a moment, because the achievements you were supposed to get were belied. I can tell you ki hum teachers ki taraf se hame क्योंकि अनफॉर्चुनेटली ज़्यादा अनुभव है, तो जिस सबने जेनुटा और जेएनयू टीचर्स का रोल सराहा, जो अचीवमेंट टीचर्स उस टाइम कर सके कि स्टूडेंट्स के साथ खड़े हुए, वॉज बिकॉज कि हमें मालूम था कि जो आज हो रहा है यूनिवर्सिटी के साथ ये लिखा हुआ है, अगर ये लोग बिल्कुल इमिडिएटली अनकंटेस्टेड इनको जीतने दिया जाए. जो हमने जो उस टाइम हमने डिसाइड किया कि हमारे पास जो हमारे पास हथियार थे वो हथियार पॉपुलर मोबिलाइजेशन, जो अपनी लाइफ ऑफ द माइंड से जो हम जिस तरीके से लड़ सकते हैं. तो आप सोचिए कि अगर किसी स्टेट के फोर्स को अगर आप लेक्चर देकर के डिफीट कर सकते हैं तो वो हमने किया. पर उस हथियार का उस जैसे अगले डेढ़ साल में यूनिवर्सिटी का जो हाल हुआ है, उस डेढ़ साल में आपको लगता है कि ये लाइफ ऑफ द माइंड, ये जो एक हथियार है ऑफ द इंटेलेक्ट, ऑफ टुगेदरनेस, ऑफ कम्युनिटी, दैट दिस वेपन हैज़ बीन ब्लंटेड. ये इम्प्रेशन हमें ज़रूर मिलता है कि हम अब तो कोई लेक्चर करा के वाइस चांसलर को हरा नहीं सकता. तो ये जो आप देख रहे हैं जे एन यू में, मैं और उसके बारे में मैं थोड़ा बात ज़रूर करना चाहूँगी क्योंकि अगले साल ये सबसे पहले हमारी जे एन यू हमारी रणभूमि रहनी चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर हमें लड़ना है एट द सैफ्रन अटैक ऑन यूनिवर्सिटीज़ देन वी हैव टू फाइट इन जे एन यू. सो आई विल स्पेंड सम टाइम टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट लेइंग आउट फॉर यू एग्जैक्टली व्हाट द इशूज़ आर इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस इन द नेक्स्ट ईयर, एंड दे आर इशूज़ बिफोर द स्टूडेंट्स यूनियन बट दे आर ऑल्सो इशूज़ बिफोर ईच स्टूडेंट. बट इन द नेक्स्ट 1.5 ईयर फ्रॉम जुलाई 2016 जो हमने देखा है दैट एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जिस्टेंस, every institutional framework, जो भी ढांचा है, जो कानून का ढांचा है, जो कस्टम का ढांचा है, जो यूनिवर्सिटी का एक्चुअली जो फाउंडेशन है, डायलॉग डिस्कशन, बिकॉज ये आज भी मैं खड़ी हुई हूँ, नॉट गोइंग टू गेट द फ्लोर फॉर एवर, दैट हैज़ बीन डिसमेंटल. नाउ व्हेन इंस्टीट्यूशन, देन व्हाट आर यू स्टैंडिंग फॉर? जो इंस्टीट्यूशन, अब हम अपने आप को असली JNU ज़रूर बुला लें, पर हर यूनिवर्सिटी में यही हुआ है आज तक लास्ट ईयर में. जो आप, लेट्स लुक एट द मेन इश्यूज दैट वी हैव बिफोर अस, एडमिशंस, एमफिल, पीएचडी डीलिंकिंग, बाकी सब यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में ये एक्चुअली इफेक्ट हो गया. यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हैदराबाद में एमफिल प्रोग्राम ही डिसअपीयर कर गया बहुत सारे डिसिप्लिन से, और वहाँ आवाज़ नहीं उठ पाई. डीलिंकिंग ऑफ एमफिल पीएचडी तो बहुत यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में ऑलरेडी था ही. सारी जो नई यूनिवर्सिटीज़ हैं वहाँ एडमिशन्स नहीं हुए एमफिल पीएचडी के, एक, दो, तीन, और कोई. तो रिसर्च को जिस तरीके से ख़त्म करना है, दिस इज़ अ नेशनल प्रोग्राम. UGC के रेगुलेशंस बने और इस विद दिस एक्सप्रेसिव है. GS कैश हर जगह, जो हमने अभी लॉस्ट आवर जेंडर सेंसिटाइजेशन कमिटी, आपने देखा है कि BHU में किस तरीके से वार हुआ है फॉर पीपल डिमांडिंग. अब वो अभी कोर्ट में है मामला, बट आई डोंट नो वेदर ये मामला कोर्ट से, इस कोर्ट केस से सॉल्व हो पाएगा. पर वहाँ भी जो आपके साथ हो रहा है वो बड़े पैमाने में दूसरी जगह हो रहा है, और वहाँ से एक आवाज़ नहीं उठाई जा रही है. फैकल्टी अपॉइंटमेंट्स, मैं आई इमेजिन कि एक कोई एक देर इज़ अ डार्क रूम समवेयर वेयर देर इज़ अ मैप ऑफ इंडिया एंड द मैप ऑफ RSS शाखाज, एंड देन पीपल फ्रॉम ईच शाखा आर बींग प्लेस्ड इन एवरी यूनिवर्सिटी. आई हैव पर्सनली हर्ड ऑफ सो मैनी अकाउंट्स वेयर द काइंड ऑफ फैकल्टी अपॉइंटमेंट्स यू आर सीइंग इन JNU, those faculty appointments are happening without question in places like University of Hyderabad, EFL University, where kuch university mein to vice chancellor bhi nahi upasthit hote hain. Actually koi professor jo sangh ka aadmi hai, he is officiating in the interviews. So each of the things that we have before us right now is something that you will see in every university. But I would like to, because we've taken a lot of time and there's a lot to talk about, I would like you to compare this with what has happened in school education. Hame kuch malum hai ki school education mein kya ho raha hai? Right. Yeah. It's actually happening in every subject that there is a certain, because textbooks, if you look at the 90s when you were all children, unfortunately, but when you look at the last NDA government from now 20 years ago, this was the big issue. They didn't have the courage to attack university. School textbooks, and us pe actually practically election bhi lade gaye, and there was that changing the history, changing the social science textbook. Now what is happening is that there is a message which is now coming from every minister. So we will, because we like Donald Trump, suddenly hum intelligent design mein believe karenge. If you haven't seen an ape turn into a man, right, then it didn't happen. So this positivistic, highly idiotic, illogical reasoning is something that is actually being planted in school education. But is there any talk about it? No. So there is, you know, you have to ferret deep in the internet, or if you're on some WhatsApp groups, then you will know that Dinanath Batra's textbooks are being adopted everywhere. True that the media is paid, but there are no organizations left of school teachers, because the RSS has been working on this since 77, and school education. So the basic message of communalism, secularism, and all, how all unity and diversity, जो हमें अपनी textbook से मिलता था, अब वो textbooks में नहीं है, तो exam papers में नहीं है. So you can see that, you know, there is the base on which today we are standing, because we still came out of something which was a little better. That base is being cut away. तो universities में जो अब अगले साल And if Modi gets a second term, who is going to come 3 years from now in a BA undergraduate classroom in Jawaharlal Nehru University or Delhi University, is going to be somebody who does not have secular values, who may have never met. There's somebody who is going to be totally arraigned against reservation. Because I think that the first issue, and I will come to what I think, I'll lay out for you what the issues are. The first thing is that reservation is under attack in this university like nowhere before. Other universities, the most probably nobody is giving us the figures. Some of you might have read the Janota releases on our last year 2017-18 admission, and you know ki numbers kya hain. According to the university, 6 Dalits were offered admission, right, for the whole MPhil PhD program. Actually, out of it's not clear to me that actually 6 were offered, but that is what their statistics say. My own count says 3, but they say 6. Chalo maan liya. Usme se about 2 have joined. So you have a batch of 159 students, out of which only 2 are Dalit. In OBCs, a similar decline. ST, one has joined, and one has joined from, and that person is, the one who has joined is from outside the quota. Now you might think that because seats kam ho gai, so isliye itna, there is such a shortage. But the whole architecture of the way that the admissions was done, right, the process will ensure that most people from reserved categories are going to be out at the written stage alone. Because we do not get statistics about the figures, about how many people qualified from the Viva, from the JNU official statistic, we can't say. But you remember, and this is going to happen in this exam too, in the 2017-18 exam, 50% cut off. Very few people generally clear a 50% cut off. Pehle JNU mein kya hota tha? JNU mein you had a pass mark in the written, which is very low, and you went down the list, and where the last, if you had 20 intake, you drew the line, right? And that was your, there was, so it was a dynamic pass mark to be able to qualify for the Viva. Whatever was the top, as long as you were above the minimum which was there in the written, it was some 27.5 out of 70 for the general and down to 15 for the SCST. If you got above that, you were qualified for the Viva. You had to call thrice the number of people. And then in the Viva Vose, after the Viva Vose, deprivation points were added and you got your final list. So in every year, and we've shown only statistics for the last 3 years, but actually in every year in JNU, we have always offered more than our intake is. And this time, offer was the less than intake. So intake was 290. The number of seats that were offered were 159. So, and of those 131 seats, what were the seats left vacant? 100 were reserved seats. Now, if you put this in the context of the national program on of the RSS-BJP on reservation, ek unka electoral plank hai, which is to consolidate, let's say, non-Jadav votes or non-Yadav votes, right? That is an electoral program, but nationally, they are consolidating, they are encouraging dominant castes within the rural, particularly rural elites, to challenge what reservation is. RSS is on record saying ki reservation nahi hona chahiye. This is being enacted in JNU. The most astonishing violations that you never thought could ever happen. There is a rule that if you have applied for a reserved a seat, but you get as much marks as somebody who is in the open category, then you are going to be in the open category. Is baar JNU admissions mein ye nahi hua hai. Cut off mark in, I forget what, computer sciences or something, is 80 for general 80 for SC. That means the persons who got above 80 from the SC category. So it is to make reservation something which is meaningless. It doesn't get the educationally disadvantaged. And in this small set of admissions, it's happened thrice. In three cases, identical cutoff marks. Now, who do we go to with this? We cannot go to, I mean, we can go to the court, but we won't get an answer. We can't go to UGC. We can't go to MHRD. We can't go anywhere because nobody is interested in the violation of reservation. Now, why am I harping on so much about reservation? This university's diversity comes from the reservation policy and the deprivation points. Both have now been eliminated. When we don't have diversity, and I'm making what I think is very dear to my heart, that JNU's excellence, JNU ki jo har taraf jo hame daad milti hai, that people hamari tarif karte hain bahar ki badi universities se, isliye karte hain kyunki jo work, jo kaam hamare students karte hain, kyunki unka personal experience itna varied hai, especially social science or humanities mein. That is what makes their research unique. अगर हम दिल्ली, पंजाब, राजस्थान के बड़े-बड़े शहरों के लोगों से को पढ़ाएंगे और वो जो रिसर्च करेंगे, तो उस रिसर्च में क्या यूनिकनेस होगी compared to somebody that who actually has a different lived experience than and you educate that patient. So JNU's excellence is under threat. It also means कि अगर इसको आप MPhil, PhD डीलिंगिंग के साथ जोड़िए and MPhil, PhD डीलिंगिंग आप अगर साथ जोड़ते हैं तो आप अगर MA के बाद PhD के लिए अप्लाई कर सकते हैं और वहाँ से एडुकेटेड सेंटर से लोग इफ दे अप्लाई दे हैव मोर एक्सेस टू मटेरियल दे हैव हैड अ बेटर अंडरग्रेजुएट पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट एजुकेशन उन में दे आर लाइकली टू परफॉर्म बेटर when there is it after MA applying direct PhD. So slowly, and actually not so slowly, in about, I would say about 2 years time, the demographic of the research university will completely change. And that is going to, is an academic loss. It's not only a social justice loss. Okay. You can add to this the whole design. Rather than looking at each, har din circular nikalte hain, har din hum gussa hote hain. पर उसका ब्रॉडर डिज़ाइन देखना ज़रूरी है अब शायद अभी जो स्टूडेंट्स ने अभी टेक अप नहीं किया है पर दैट इज़ गोइंग टू बी ऑल्सो टीचर्स आर वेरी वरीड अबाउट इट वो स्काइप वाइवास का जो है दैट इज़ गोइंग टू दीज आर एक्सट्रीमली आई मीन नो वाइवा वो से इन एनी यूनिवर्सिटी फॉर रिसर्च डिग्री इज़ हेल्ड ओवर स्काइप पर जो उनने रूल्स बनाए हैं उसके तहत जो चीज़ें हम करते आए हैं जिससे बिकॉज वी बिलीव दैट एजुकेशन इज़ अ कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस और JNU में MPhil PhD लेवल पे भी बहुत सारे लोग आते हैं जो JNU से MA नहीं किया है जिनने तो ऑब्वियसली अगर दूसरी अच्छी यूनिवर्सिटी से आए हो जहाँ भी हो तो दैट्स अ डिफरेंट इशू बट बहुत सारे लोग आते हैं जिनको हु हैव नॉट हैड द बेनिफिट ऑफ अ वेरी गुड एजुकेशन सो MPhil फॉर देम इज़ देयर फर्स्ट डिग्री इन आर सिस्टम ऑफ एजुकेशन तो अभी जो JNU सिस्टम में है कि दोनों एग्जामिनर MPhil डिसर्टेशन को साथ इवेल्यूएट करते हैं अब वो हटा दिया गया है और सिर्फ वो एक्सटर्नल एग्जामिनर साथ इवेल्यूएशन से ये होता है हमें मालूम है कितने मिनिमम CGPA रिक्वायरमेंट है टू प्रोसीड टू डू अ PhD तो एक्चुअली जो जनरल डिज़ाइन है हर वक्त कि स्टूडेंट्स को निकालो रिजर्वेशन को ख़त्म करो मेक इट एम्प्टी मीनिंगलेस समथिंग दैट इज ओनली गिवन टू द एक्सेलेंट राइट एंड दैट मीन्स दैट वॉट एवर नंबर ऑफ सीट्स यू हैव Whether you have 720 or 1550, the general design is one that you will always underfill seats, about 50 to 60%. So next year's admission might be a little better, but their design is to make sure that JNU does not get these seats. Now, put it together with this, the general UGC program of institutions of eminence, right? That the aim there is to say, okay, so we have excellent teachers, who cares about the students? We should get more excellent students, as if our students are not excellent already. Right? And to make sure that only a certain class comes, JNU will be able to charge fees. He's made the application. He's made the application on institutions of eminence. Some centers have foolishly collaborated. And this means, and 30% foreign students is going to be the willful charging of user fees. People from industry, so Nandan Nilekani will come and teach us about social justice. Right? So, and about 20 to 25% foreign faculty. At the same time, right now you cannot invite anybody to be a visiting professor in your university. So we, the excellence built up in this university by students and teachers, right, is now about to be sold. And I see that, and therefore removing reservation, because removing reservation by tricking the system, right, 50%, etc., etc. This is what lies in store. And if this government, so JNU will remain excellent, but it will be excellent without all of you. This is not far away. This is in the future. And it is with this design that I think it is important to. So all institutions that involve any popular participation, JNU, SU, JNU, TA, GS, CASH, all of these institutions which allegedly call trouble, which give power to the people, have to be erased. Now, partly, of course, it is that JNU se sak nafrat hai, right? Aur isko khatam karna hi hai. And at the, it is also part of this. So we should not say, make it completely deterministic ki kyunki inko eminence karna hai, privatize karna hai, isliye kar rahe hain. Bahut sari cheeze aise hoti hain. Now this same design, we see what it has done to other universities. Not a voice of protest. Now who are the people who are going to resist this? And how are we going to resist it? Now last year, ye baat actually kafi charcha mein sab taraf hui hai pichle saal ki, humne JNU Teachers Association ne ye kya, isme JNU SU ka koi is tarike se role nahi tha, student organizations ka role nahi tha, ki humne socha ki hum isko pehle, hum naively humne socha ki hume prevent karna hai, ki ye na ho, ki hum prevent kar sakte hain. Aur humne dekha, hum court gaye, hum teen cases ke sath court mein hain. Aur if you look at it at the face of it, ki lagta hai ki koi result nahi mile. But actually, ye main daave se keh sakti hu, and I'm not a sentimental, emotional person or egoistic, that agar hum nahi gaye hote, to jo pace pe yahan cheeze ye hone wali thi, wo pace kahin zyada, uska kahin zyada raftaar hoti. Faculty appointments mein aap jante hain ki बहुत एंड वो सच्ची मुझ में एक्चुअली जेएनयू टीचर्स के लिए सबसे बड़ा मुद्दा है कि वाइस चांसलर ने अपने आप को पावर दे दिया है कि वो हर सब्जेक्ट में एक्सपर्ट जो आते हैं सिलेक्शन कमेटी के खुद नियुक्त करेंगे. ही विल कॉल हूएवर ही वांट्स. सो स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड एस्थेटिक्स में एक डांसर को बुला लिया गया. कोई सितार बजाता है तो उसको स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड एस्थेटिक्स सिलेक्शन कमेटी में बुला दिया. गुरुकुल कांगड़ी यूनिवर्सिटी जो इतनी मशहूर यूनिवर्सिटी है हरिद्वार की, जहां एक्चुअली अभी बेचारी डिमोट हुई है, अब कॉलेज बन गया है फिर से, वहां से एक्सपर्ट आता है इंग्लिश लिटरेचर के लिए, अब वो अंग्रेजी नहीं बोल पाते हैं. इस तरीके से और कोई एक डिसिप्लिन में कोई दूसरा डिसिप्लिन में बैठे. एंशंट इंडियन हिस्ट्री के इंटरव्यूज होते हैं, उसमें मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री और मिडिवल हिस्ट्री के लोग बैठे हुए. एंड जो लोग सजेस्ट जो वहाँ इलेक्ट हो रहे हैं, वहाँ सिलेक्शन कमिटीज़ में दो चीज़ें होती है. एक तो जब उनको सूट करता है तो कहा जाता है कि जेएनयू के स्टूडेंट को, जो भी अप्लाई किया है जेएनयू के स्टूडेंट ने, उनको अलग कर दो. ये बहुत सारे इंटरव्यूज में हुआ. जहाँ जेएनयू का स्टूडेंट अपना होता है, वहाँ माने राइट काइंड राइट आइडियोलॉजी का होता है, वहाँ ये बात बोली नहीं जाती. अगर चेयरपर्सन और डीन अगर नोट ऑफ डिसेंट दिए जाए तो उनको अपने पद से निकाल दिया जाता है, जैसे निवेदिता मेनन के साथ हुआ. तीन और फैकल्टी को इस तरीके से थ्रेटन किया गया है. नाउ दोज इंटरव्यू द चेंजिंग द टीचिंग कैरेक्टर ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्सिटी, ये इनका एजेंडा है. जनवरी 3 जनवरी को इनने अपने आप को ये पावर दिया और हम शायद मार्च या अप्रैल में हमने कोर्ट केस फाइल किया. उस साल में जहाँ इनने सिलेक्ट इतना प्रेशर किया है, वो सिर्फ 34 अपॉइंटमेंट कर पाए हैं. 34 हमारे लिए बहुत है, पर अगर हम कोर्ट में जीतेंगे तो ये अपॉइंटमेंट कैंसिल हो जाएंगे. पर वो अब ये हमारे हाथ में नहीं है, पर जहाँ तक लड़ना है, क्योंकि टोटली इस वाइस चांसलर को 308 अपॉइंटमेंट करने हैं, उसमें से दैट इज अभी JNU फैकल्टी की स्ट्रेंथ इज अराउंड 600, हाफ द नंबर ऑफ पीपल ही हैज टू हायर. नाउ दिस इज अ शॉर्ट वे टू चेंज द यूनिवर्सिटी. आयरोनिकली मेनी यूनिवर्सिटीज में हमारे लोग आउट ऑफ पैनल, हमारे रेक्टर जाके एक सोशियोलॉजी के इंटरव्यू में, ही इज नॉट अ सोशियोलॉजिस्ट बट ही हैज सर्व्ड एज एन एक्सपर्ट. दिस इज आई सेड हैपनिंग अक्रॉस यूनिवर्सिटीज, बट द रेजिस्टेंस इज कमिंग हियर. आई वी बिलीव दैट वी हैव हेल्ड हिम बैक. एडमिशन का जो मामला है, मेनी पीपल हैव ट्राइड, इंडिविजुअल्स हैव ट्राइड. फ्रॉम डिसम्बर लास्ट ईयर we began to see some results and I am confident. But if you don't challenge, because there is no other court before us, there is no UGC, there is no MHRD, there is, and we must be realistic ki popular resistance mein jab 25,000 ke fine lagenge and you are in the threat of your service condition, aapka jo popular mobilization आप करना चाहते हैं वो नहीं होगा. ये नहीं कि जो लोग नहीं आए डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन में वो मान गए. सो व्हाट इज लाइज अहेड ऑफ अस, दिस नेक्स्ट ईयर इज एज साकेत सेड एक्सट्रीमली क्रूशियल. देर आर प्लेसेस वेयर देर इज नो रेजिस्टेंस बट देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ एंगर इन अमंग स्टूडेंट्स, एंड स्टूडेंट्स आर द वंस दैट कैन चेंज द वर्ल्ड. In 2010, 2011, the students of Chile started to protest about, because they only had essentially a private education system in terms of fees, humongous fees. And Chile, though there are some inequality, is huge all over Latin America, extremely. And so students, like all of us, you know, I come from a middle class family in Delhi, but if the fees was 25,000 rupees, in JNU, I would not have been able to study here. I'm the fourth of the fifth child. My father had died at the age of 60. There was no way I could have done a PhD. The students of Chile started in 2011, these protests. University of Chile remained, I'm not saying shut down JNU, but the vice chancellor is trying to do that, so we should keep it open. This University of Chile was closed for, I think, practically a year. Just 4 days ago, the country has passed a law making all higher education free in the country. So what should be an inspiration? I mean, I know Facebook seems like a good place to protest, but our inspiration has to come from those struggles. It may be that Modi gets a second term, but it is articulating jo sabke haq mein hai. That is what the young always do. The youth have always been the inspiration for change. They have been the catalyst of change. And so somebody who was the person who, the woman leader of that movement was a student then and now is a legislator. So I think that to gather students together on basic demands, that is fail safe. Because let me tell you, ABVP is not saying them. The NSUI is not saying what are the basic demands. The basic demands is that you want higher education. In this country, I think now research students and postgraduate students make up well under less than 10% of university enrollment. And I think it's about 3% nationally, 52% in JNU. Over the last 10 years, 52% of our scholars, of the students here are research students. It's this that we have to fight for, the right to research, right? The right to research to ensure their social justice. So I would suggest that, of course, call out every time there is a saffronizing of the curriculum. But what they are doing is saffronizing the teachers and saffronizing the students. They are going to ensure that this diversity that I see here right now is going to be eliminated. So one must stand up for that diversity. JNU holds a very important, and I'm not trying to flatter you, at a time when no other student's body is resisting. One, it cannot be set Those students in Chile in 2011 set the agenda. When the rest of that highly neoliberal country, right, with a long history of dictatorship, nobody thought in 2011 that 7 years later you would have a law for universal free higher education. So it is that you must keep. It is not fascism, Sanghivad, you know, neo-totalitarianism or authoritarianism. These labels are not important. It's what you say to the labels that is important. So affirming reservation, affirming our deprivation points, we might not get them now, but you don't forget them. If they disappear from our discourse. Finally, I just like to say one more thing, that the struggles that we build must be not one that involve the common mass of students. As you can see, the Vice Chancellor is doing some of it for us now with the attendance issue. Right? So the common mass, it's exhilarating to hear of stories of first year BA undergraduate students refusing to sign the sheet and saying, you will leave class if you ask us for attendance. Right? And this is happening across the universities, in the science schools, because people think it's a ridiculous thing and they do not want to do it. But that is still a reactive agenda. Now, how do you get people who don't know what deprivation points are and who do not know its effect to actually understand how important it is? It's something that you need to think about. I have some ideas, but you should, like a teacher, I'm saying you have to do some thinking first. But the second issue is to involve the common mass of people. There are concerns that can, there are concerns which around particular cases become really difficult to mobilize. As a student's body, you should be proud of the fact that you fought for GS cash. But you also managed matters when there was no GS cash. So pre-1999, there was no GS cash. There was no national law. There was nothing to enable you to manage sexual harassment. Sexual harassment happens today. It's happening. Women are feeling insecure. There's nobody to turn to. The student's body, without the teachers, but can involve some teachers, of course, has to figure out a way to raise these issues of gender equality and ensuring that women have the right to say no. And it could be feeble or otherwise, I don't care. No is no. Right? So that campaign. So to keep on making your compatriots people who are secular, who are gender just. That role has to be taken up. Now that body GS cash isn't there. There is a huge anti-reservation error. It is your job to keep JNU as it is. Because we will triumph. I have no doubt about that, as long as we keep on fighting. If we believe that these things, because they are not recognized by the university administration, do not have value, then they will disappear in thin air. So I wish you all the best. And I'm willing to take questions, of course. But if there's anything that us teachers who have been in JNUSU, in left student organizations, then if anything, we may not be in Januta. But we are always there to support the just demands of students. Thank you.